My mom was so fat that it made a unicorn blush. Oh, well, your mama's so fat, she sat on a rainbow and made Skittles. Boom. I like this. You have a minute or two of the best yo mama jokes.
Hey, I got my sandwich, everybody. I love your suggestion.
Yeah.
Barbecue sauce.
Barbecue sauce.
My mom just destroyed the doctor's words. I tried to make the baby by, like, when she gave birth to a trunk and then he got crushed by his chest. My mom did that.
Okay. I love you. Just told me that when his mother gave birth to him, that she gave birth to a truck and it killed the doctor. Okay.
Ugh. Owie. I'm so funny. Fart jokes are bomb.
Your mama's so old, she took her driver's license test on a dinosaur. Oh, shit. Well, your mama's so ugly, they hang up posters of her at the zoo to keep the monkeys from beating off.
Yeah, you can blackmail people if you think you're straight.
Gonna watch my fucking Saturday morning cartoons every week or I'm showing this clip of you.
Fucking every time I rate her... her stream like plays it. She's always doing something like nice and chill and calm. And I just come in like, look at this fucking guy. Look at this fucking guy. Fucking name. Fucking name. Like a potty mouth.
Better do it. Yeah, I'm gonna give you kisses. I'm gonna tickle fight you to death and give you kisses. You gotta watch my screen. You don't want more of it. Because I imagine if like a big scary tough guy now is just that. I'm gonna hold you down and tickle you until you pee your pants. Now I'm gonna give you kisses on your face.
Hey yo, this is CeCe from Pressure Boys, the best smoke on the East Coast, and you're watching the WARR Multiverse. Sheesh.
Ah, oh, good, wonderful, phenomenal Thursday morning. And I say wonderful and phenomenal because it is gorgeous out. It is hot as balls, humid as balls, sweat and sticky. But other than that, it seems like a good day. You know, not too much wind over here, not too much, a little bit of this, a little bit of that. So, you know, those of you who have been tuning in, appreciate all of you for everything. And as you know now, where the Burning Bush now is available for a podcast, as well as your Saturday morning stream, WARR Independence News Network, winning, is now also available as a podcast. So, go on Spotify. Go on fucking Amazon Music, Audible, Apple Podcasts, and you can get the podcast there now. If you're like, well, I'm a fucking guy who doesn't use any of that shit, well, you use Google Podcasts or Pandora or whatever, it'll be there soon enough. We're just waiting for it to fucking approve, you know? It's some fucking annoying bullshit. They're like, oh, and fucking Pandora's the worst. It says that it could take up to 2 to 14 weeks to get approved on that shit. I'm like, what? Fucking Apple and Amazon and everybody, like, fucking approve that shit immediately. Real quick. But since this show is available as a podcast now, you don't have to... If you just want to listen to it, you could wait till it gets revealed on the podcast. And, you know, once you click the follow button on the podcast show, you add the show to your library, it'll automatically update you when there's a new show. Of course, you all know how the fucking internet works. And so, but I thought, I says, oh, well, let me do a little something different for the stream, for those who are watching live on stream. So, if you can't tell, you can actually see my face now on the burning bush. My face is right there, coming right out of the bush, almost like a hologram. That was actually the point. Yeah, the point was that it was almost like a hologram. That was the reason for it to be like this, because the show is supposed to be all about, you know, you just listen in and take it and part it in, you know, you take part in the conversation by blowing up the chat, you know, and you come in. But I wanted to do something special for those of you who tune in live stream, especially those of you who rewatch later on. A lot of you love to rewatch the show, and it's awesome. I fucking love it. I appreciate all of you. Hit that follow button. We're almost at affiliate. Hit that shit. Get in here on the stream. Chat with your Lord live. You know, and you see me coming straight out of the burning bush like a hologram. And you know why I thought this was cool? Because this is exactly what Moses described as he saw. He saw a face holographically coming out of the flames. That's what he described. He said there was a face within the flames, and thereupon he looked the face of the Lord. Right? So, what ancient alien theorists, what do they believe? Well, they believe that it's possible that he was using a hologram, and the Lord was using, if we want to talk about it as a technological device, it's possible that the Lord, that the burning bush was nothing more than a, you know, a misidentified or mistermed hologram device. I mean, you know, even today, I mean, you think about it, it's basically the same thing as FaceTime, but projected into the universe instead of just being on a screen. You know what I'm saying? Like, it's just projected upwards from the screen and out into the world to make it more three-dimensional. So, it's really just the same thing. So, I mean, it makes a lot of sense, you know, that it would be like that. So I thought that would be pretty funny to put the picture in there like that. Now, so we got a lot going on over here this week. So I wanted to talk today about, we're revisiting our original topic of World at War. That was episode 2's title. First we did Welcome to WARR. WARR! Then we did World at War, right? And now this is World at War 2. I'm not going to say World War 2 because I don't want you to think I'm talking about World War 2. No. I'm talking about the world being at war again, right? Not just for the first time, the second time. Why does that relate to today a lot? Well, we are about, you know, 107 years ago was World War One, you know, and and at the same time was also the fucking fall of the Russian monarchy into the Soviet Union, and also, you know, around the same time, a little bit into the future, you know, right now we're talking about a recession right now in the world, but we are, you know, it's not, we're only, what, freaking 7 years, 6.5 years away from fucking, or 7.5 years away from fucking 100 years from the Great Depression. And we're talking about another big recession going on. Oh, yeah, jobs are joining, sure. We're adding jobs, you know, but at the same time, we're not adding jobs. I don't understand it. So, we are revisiting the topics of the past in order to talk about the present and the future. So, you know, in World War II, we got way out of hand, because after World War I, nobody wanted to have another world war. Nobody wanted that to happen. So, what they did was, is they would appease Hitler's conquests. They would appease Soviet Union conquests. They would appease, you know, let them do their areas of, you know, of taking over. You know, let them secede the territory into their country in order to, you know, avoid an all-out conflict. And then we obviously know what happened after that. I mean, you know, we had the outbreak of World War II, and then after World War II, we had the Cold War, you know, and which was an arms race slash technological race between the two world's most leading powers, the United States and the Soviet Union. So, it was a very, and that lasted decades, by the way, in case you don't remember. That lasted decades, you know? So, the mode of appeasement doesn't work, you know? And we learned that lesson, apparently. Finally, we at least learned something over here. You know what, let's get our favorite thing in here. I don't know if D-Rock's in here, but D-Rock loves this one, so we're gonna play this one.
Smoke weed every day.
I forgot he's live now too for morning meditation. I forgot about that. But, you know, we're fucking chilling over there. So, we're fucking chilling. He's chilling, we're chilling, we're talking about the world. We're talking about politics, philosophy, history, emotional shit that happened. The response as to what actually happened. So, you know, we had the Cold War. And it was also a space race as well. It wasn't just an arms race, you know, and they like to paint it out to be as a, you know, a fight for democracy versus totalitarianism or a capitalism versus communism, you know. It's not really what it's about. You know, it wasn't about that for them, and it's really not what it's about at all. You know, it's just what everybody wants to paint it out to be, because everybody likes to simplify things into such, you know, black and white, gray territories, you know, where there's no gray area, there's no gray territory that they're allowed to go, because they don't want it, they just want a summed up final answer. And, you know, and that's the problem with scientists versus ancient alien theorists also, is because whether the facts are there, you know, you look at it and you go, well, I don't see, like, the whole big picture, you know, it doesn't give, like, a crisp, clear answer, and you're like, well, of course not, it's not a crisp, clear topic, you're talking about, you know, hundreds of thousands of years, and you want it summed up to a sentence? It's not that simple, you know, you can't just fucking sum it up to a sentence. So, it's fucking crazy. So, you know, that's the other thing, you know, is you have, you know, Moses didn't just go up to the burning bush and talk to God the one time before he went to see Pharaoh, and then the second time when he brought the Israelites to get the Ten Commandments from God. Now, and even then, you know, God broke it into 10 basic rules. You know, the basic rules of everything, and he had to simplify it so much that it's like, it's just, you know, I mean, he simplified it to a level where, you know, it's just gotta be 10 short, quick sentences, you know, not even sentences, just statements, proclamations, you know, summaries, just short and quick. And, you know, so it's the same thing. But he didn't just go there those two times. He went dozens of times over there. And, you know, he spent like 40 days up with God composing the Ten Commandments. So even God probably was like, oh, you know, this shit's too long. They're not going to get this. They're not going to understand this. And it's like, you know, what's going on there. So, you know, you got to take it all into perspective. I mean, not even that's not, you know, a short history. I mean, you see the Torah, you see the freaking Bible. Neither one of those books are fucking short, in any sense. Like, you know, so it's a tougher over there, but. So, nothing wraps up into a one sentence, and that's why we have this continuous talk with the burning bush, because there's continuous topics to explore that all lead to the same final topic, the same understanding, which we'll get to in the future. But for now, we're not going to get to that. For now, we're going to continue talking about why the world is at war again. So, now we have these problems going on with, we spoke in the past about how there is a rise in racism and anti-Semitism. I'm fixing my chair over here. I don't know if you can hear it. I'm trying to, like, sit ultra comfy, you know, while also talking to you through this hologram. You know, of a screen, whatever it may be, it's a hologram. So, fix my pillow over here, you know what I'm saying? Get all nice and comfy for me, get all nice and comfy for you. So, you know, it isn't so simple, and we can't even just talk about modern history and what's going on today in a few sentences. I mean, we've talked about it and revisited topics over and over again, excuse me.
Samurai Pizza Cats.
Samurai Pizza Cats, and you know you straight whack. Alright.
Can't even get a pepperoni slice like that. 2 for 5. Trying to stay alive with a fountain drink on the side.
Fountain drink on the side, and I'll dip my fry into the hot barbecue sauce. Yeah, I'm sitting here getting sauced, or you call it lit, you don't give a fuck, I don't care about none of it. And I'm just sitting here chilling on the beat with my homie D-Rock rocking your street.
Knock the streets back, and I don't give a fuck. You already know I had to call that like an umpire and an empire.
The two clans agreed to the peace treaty, and they joined some months later to attend his wedding ceremony. And she was already pregnant with some other man's baby. And the reception appeared to be harmonious, but something sinister lurked beneath the surface. Boom! Called it! I was just joking around, and already beneath the surface, something sinister, some other man's baby, I'm telling you. Look, see? She's wearing, like...
blood. You got diabetes!
Alright, I'm fucking back. Sorry about that. So, that's the good thing about the Be Right Back scene now, too. Especially if you're fucking, listening to it on a podcast, you get to hear little clips from a whole bunch of shows, especially sometimes from a show that you didn't see. Like, for example, you know, if you're just listening to this, you have no idea that, you know, now you can see my face on the burning bush. And now, let's do this again.
Comment. Smoke weed every day. Hold up. Oh,
was I just talking about now? So we have the world at war again. So everything is at war. Everybody's at war right now. We have the rise of racism, anti-Semitism. We have the rise of totalitarianism. We have a rise of military coups going on, rebellions, you know, a bunch of presidents being overthrown, parliaments dissolving, and a whole bunch of countries. We talked about this over and over again, you know. I mean, it's the same thing all the time, just like how 100 years ago, it's the same thing that we're kind of living through again now. You know, everybody was worried about war, except the only difference, like I was about to say before, is the only difference is, and this is the one time we seem to actually learn a lesson, is because, you know, now we don't want to do what we did in World War II and appease, you know, those who are trying to take over or do the wrong thing. We don't want to just fucking appease them. You know, we want to you know, stop it before it even happens, before it gets too crazy, before it gets too fucking, before it gets to just be too much. You know, we want to stop that, and we don't want that to happen. So now we take these immediate precautions, which, you know, we are, like we've discovered in later topics, it's all divided. You know, it's all because we let one country do the same thing, but we punish another country for the exact same thing. Which, how's that? Ooh, excuse me. How's that punishment going so far? It ain't going pretty well at all. That's what I'll tell you. It ain't going well at all. Punishment ain't going well at all. And why isn't it going well? Well, you know, one of the things we'll talk about on Saturday, but it brings up right now, is that, you know, they're lowering sanctions again on Russian oil, and they agreed to pump more oil into Europe and sell it to other areas of the world that need it, you know, like Africa. So, you know, it's not really working out. Plus, their economy is doing great. Their money is doing pretty well. You know, inflation is hitting them a little bit too, but not like us. Well, you know, maybe like us, but in a different way. You know, it's hitting their economy somewhat differently than it's hitting our economy. So, and, you know, plus, like I said before, all that money is just going to fucking... It's just going to fucking the fucking people. I mean, it's just the gasoline is going back into their economy. It's going back into fucking everybody else's economy, and you know they agreed to sell more oil to Iran and to fucking China. So what does that mean? Well, that means that our oil is off the market because they can just do another deal with Saudi Arabia, who has a better relationship with them than with us. And, you know, and they can just do another deal. And then what? Then the little bit of oil that we have is being dealt less to us and more to them. And then it's also, you know, our oil is not being bought. You know, the companies that we own, you know, is not being bought, or our people own, however you want to put it. So, it's not. How do I put this over here? You know, the world is at war again right now. We got, you know, the rebellion in Nigeria, Ethiopia, Myanmar still. We got Chinese aggression towards, well, I don't even know if I wanna, well, maybe now it might be aggression with weapons training and literally a blockade around their island, but before then, I would say strong rhetoric is the actual case, because it's pretty much what it was. I mean, you know, strong rhetoric. So you know, the boom, super great. Thanks for interrupting my thought, Nancy. Goodbye. So, yeah, you post in, but you don't even fucking count yourself as a fucking viewer. You suck. You fucking suck, bitch. Are you fucking kidding me? Goodbye. Good fucking bye. Now. So anyway, you know, I'm at war with people like that. I'm at fucking war with people like that, by the way. Because, you know, I'm over here trying to fucking have a conversation. I don't need you to tell me what's going on right now. Tell me later. I'm fucking spamming my shit right now. I'm fucking at war with you. That's what I am. Because, you know what, I'm fucking... So then we got... Oh my god, we got all the problems in fucking South America, South Africa, North Africa, Central America. None of the American countries can get along. And fucking on fucking... You know, it's like, nobody can get along. We can't get along with ourselves. They fucking can't get along with, you know, we can't even get along with our neighbors to the north. You know, they get along with everybody. And especially themselves, most of the time at least. So, the point is, I mean, you know, look, you got your, Europe ousting their fucking, prime minister. You got Israel dissolving their parliament, Sri Lanka dissolving their parliament. I mean, you know, China's claiming Taiwan as their area. Russia's doing the same thing with Ukraine. I mean, you know, China was basically just looking for an excuse to do this. You know, and Nancy Pelosi gave them one. That's really it. So, you know, it's fucking ridiculous. So, then after all of that, we got... Delete. So, if then we got fucking... you know, it seems like we, even if we learn a lesson, we learn the wrong lesson. You know, one, you can't just shoot somebody's, you know, feelings, beliefs, or whatever straight down like that. Like, no, you're fucking ridiculous. No, because it's obviously not working. It's not working here in this country. It's not working in any fucking country. You know, I mean, you know, you either get people who rebel, or you get the fucking military who rebels, or you get, you know, just some guy taking over. You know, I mean, that's the whole thing. And, you know, and you just, you don't want him in. That shit fucking really annoyed me right now. Like, really fucking annoyed me. You know, that was two things right in a row that really fucking pissed me off just now. It's a gorgeous day out, not too windy, and the reason I say it's not too windy, although it looks more windy now, fuck me, is because I want to fly the drone around. and get practice with it, because there's a way to like set it up so it, you know, follows you around and records, and like you can even set a specific flight path. So if I wanted to like start up and then pan down, you know, I can do that and have it you know, use it to like film. And then I can just possibly even either use the audio that's on it, but probably not, because the fan blades are loud, so I would probably just put the audio over it, which is fine, because I got this great fucking program that's, it's real simple to do. You know, you just mute the audio on one thing and then drag the audio over, you know, extend the time so it matches the time frame. And, you know, in editing. You know, you do a little editing. You know what I'm saying? So we get in there and we do a bunch of editing. So then I'm watching this fucking other shit earlier. And I was watching about how, you know, I was watching this shit about, speaking of the burning bush, I was watching this shit about Medusa. And not just only about Medusa, but all of the Greek gods pretty much, and a bunch of the demigods. You know, it was like, it's like a mini series that the History Channel was doing, or maybe it's a full series and there's more episodes to come. I don't know. You know, there were a lot of gods. They can do like 200 something episodes. So, you know, you have fucking, the gods were even doing all this fighting. They were always at war with themselves, with each other. You know, after Zeus was taking control, they tried to fucking overthrow him. His wife did, and they didn't even fucking succeed. It's crazy. Well, these gods are crazy. Even though they're immortal, it's like you could like chain them down for forever. I mean, that's what happened to Prometheus. You know, he's fucking chained down forever with an eagle pecking at his liver. You know, so just because he gave fire to man, isn't that crazy? Which in the Bible, the same person who did that was Lucifer and his followers. Zeus, Lucifer, Quetzalcoatl, Kukulkan, Odin. They were all the same person. Even in Hinduism, you have the fight between fucking Rama and Vishnu. You know? Which one is the, which for the fight for power, you know? But even the Sumerians, you know, when I was just also I finished one of the Zachariah Sitchin books, actually the first book in one of the series that he wrote, so the 12th planet, I finished that one, the audiobook version of, and even he talked about how the gods were at war with each other, and they were fighting, and they were even, you know, there was a rebellion of the gods, because the gods didn't want to toil in the mines anymore on their own. They needed a worker race. So then, you know, the gods were appeased them, and they supposedly created man to be as their worker race for them, so they didn't have to do you know, all the work themselves. So when you put everything together, it starts to make sense, and this is why it takes so long to talk about. But you'll only listen if a burning bush tells you. So that's why I'm telling you this way. So then, you know, we also have you know, so the gods were at war to the point where they fought amongst themselves, and they created man. The gods were at war to the point of where they, you know, they even fought at the end when they wanted to let man die off in the deluge, and they didn't want to save them. You know, that's the god Enlil. And you know what's funny is these people, they're the Nephilim. They're referred to as also known as the Anunnaki, but their head supreme god is named Anu, the Almighty, the real god. So Anunnaki probably just means those of Anu. So the whole entire world is at war, including the gods, and including in Christian religions too. You have, you know, even the gods are fighting amongst themselves. There's a war between heaven and hell, supposedly, and all that shit. So, you know, everybody is fighting, and even today we're still fighting with each other. You know, there's a whole talk when I was watching Ancient Aliens, and they were like, oh, the theory that they're not coming down to us because we're still fighting amongst ourselves and they don't fight amongst themselves just seems like total BS nonsense to me. I mean, it just seems like total, you know, self-centrist. It's more centrist, you know, like it's a self-centered point of view, you know, as even if you're thinking about it in terms of the human race, it's a self-centered point of view. To think that they would be here of any, you know, for our benefit, I mean, I that doesn't even make sense. You know, maybe some of them want to see our benefit, sure, you know, maybe somebody did, you know, assign some quote-unquote watchers to watch over us, sure, maybe, but, like, again, the watchers implies a limited few, so what are we talking about, 10, 15, you know, so you got a limited view of the people here that you're talking about, and you got fucking... You know, I mean, why would they be here of themselves? You know, why are they here? Because they want to fucking do whatever they need. They're fucking thousands of years older than us. To think that what are we, their fucking pet, you know, a little kitten cat? Like, come on, they're not fucking here for our benefit. Come on, like, let's fucking be real for a second. You know, that doesn't mean that they want to harm us, you know, or cause us any, you know, devastation like we hear about in the myths and the gods, you know, maybe some of them do, I don't know, but that doesn't mean that their entire agenda is, well, if it's not for the good of us, it's for the bad of us. Like, no. It just could be that they need something and they're here and, you know, somehow and something else happened. Which, you know, what was interesting about me listening and finishing this talk about with Zachariah Sitchin and fucking his book on the 12th planet. When they spoke about the creation of man, one woman birthed the first man. So you're talking about an actual person gave birth to the first man. And then after that, there were 14 more birthing women around the first woman. So you had the first man, and then you had... So their science was advanced to the point that they said that they were going to create 7 men and 7 women. And... Which is funny because from their perspective, we're the 7th planet towards the sun. If they're all the way out in perspective, then our perspective, if they're all the way, you know, past fucking Pluto, and you start counting the planets from that planet towards the sun, we're the 7th planet. So, you know, it's like... Or the 7th heavenly body in the solar system, you know. So, you know, it's... So they had 7 men and 7 women, and their science was so advanced that they knew that each baby would be born a male or a female, you know. And then, so they had 14 women give birth to 14 humans, You know, basically like what we're doing nowadays with surrogate parents. You know, it's the same concept. They were the surrogate mothers to the birth of humanity, which in a way is also interesting because you also hear this referred to in Christian traditions for Mary. You know, Mary gave birth to the new humanity, you know, the humanity of peace with our Lord or whatever. And so she gave birth to the new humanity. And then you have, you know, the same traditions with Athena and, you know, and Zeus and Athena's women around her who, you know, serve her and are her holy priestess, the mothers of all creation, you know. So you have this consistent reference over and over again of people fighting and then the results of these fightings. And then more fighting turns into it. So the first result, so the first fighting was the gods who came here and then rebelled against their overlords, not to take over, but they wanted, you know, it was like our modern equivalent of a union strike. You know, you're not getting your union dues, so we're going on strike. You know, so that's the modern equivalent for you right there. And the other equivalent for it too is not only is it the you want to talk about fucking, you know, then they have the war with fucking humanity, right? Because after then the two gods are fighting to who wants to save humanity and who doesn't, you know. And you have who wants to destroy the planet and all the messed up creations that they made and who doesn't, you know. And you have so you have the fighting again amongst the gods, and then the eventual appeasement of everything that happened under the blessing of Lord Anu, the Supreme, you know. And then you have later on with humanity amongst itself. That's not the end of the gods fighting. Oh, no. That's only the beginning, because then you have a further rebellion too. You have the rebellion of the gods of, you know, they have the military rebellion, you know, where it's those who follow Lucifer, General Lucifer, and those who follow, you know, General Michael, the Archangel or whatever, you know, Commander Jesus. You know, I mean, it's, you know, we have these military hierarchies today, but these military hierarchies today also stem all the way back to ancient times. You know, they stem back to the military hierarchy of the gods. You know, last time we talked about it with Christianity and Hinduism and Buddhism, and I mean, you know, even Buddha established a hierarchy of himself and others. Everybody is allowed to attain, you know, his level. They can attain the same level or better, you know, Buddha says, but you also, you know, there are levels, aka there is a hierarchy, you know. So you have all these different, people saying very, very similar things, you know. And then you have people fighting amongst themselves for years. You know, we now know that humans have been around a lot longer than 10,000 years, and over 200,000 years we've been fighting all the different ancient hominids that were on this planet. You know, Homo sapiens evolved from Homo erectus, and there was also Neanderthals and the Doma people, and the there's just so many. There's over 24. You know, it's even hard for me to remember. I'm going to write all these down on a piece of paper or print it out or something so I can fucking remember it each time. Because that's what... Because I don't feel like searching for it right now. I want to continue the conversation. But also because, you know, it's... The point is you should go out there and look at it too. You know, do your own research. Don't just listen to what I'm saying and the burning bush is saying. Don't just listen to the burning bush of, you know, Christianity. Don't just listen to whatever book you read that your family's religion was. You know, go out there and learn it all. You don't have time to read, get a podcast. I know you got that earbud. You don't need to listen to the same song all the time. You don't need to listen to the same podcast all the time. Get an audio book. You know, you don't want to listen to it, you like to read, get a Kindle. You know, get fucking something. You know, those memberships are cheaper than so many other memberships. You know, Audible is a little bit more expensive than the other ones, but it's if you buy it...
You gotta get Swifty. You gotta get Swifty in here.
Swifty in here.
It's time to get Swifty. Uh-oh. You gotta get Swifty. Oh yeah. Take off your pants and your panties. Shit on the floor. Time to get Swifty in here. Gotta shit on the floor. I'm Mr. Bulldops.
Yes, I call you Mr. Bulldops. That's right. What up, yo? And KDN, person who's possibly named Kyle. What is up? Yes, Bulldops. He's not named Kyle. He's named Bulldops.
Regrets will be placated with the fact that I knew everything that I could to the best of my knowledge at the time.
The Dinobots overwhelmed us with sheer brute force.
Your mom's got a boost when I boost her with this dick. Oh!
The Dinobots baited you because you had no strategy.
I would talk about having sex with your mom, but that's not much of a brag. You know what I'm saying?
And when we have found them...
When I'm in the forest, I can summon Weston with the Weston call. You mean your lord in the burning bush, the hologram? Yeah, you like my face in the burning bush? Yeah, yeah. But don't take it from me either. You know, just take it from...
Hey yo, this is Cece from Pressure Boys, the best smoke on the East Coast, and you're watching the WARR Multiverse. Sheesh!
Yo, thanks, man. Yeah, we are going to manifesting flight and love. You know, we're fucking hanging out over here. We're talking about the world. What's a new one? No, that's a clip. So if you don't have a clip on your channel, then you just get the shout out. But, oh, it didn't work. I didn't put the space. No problem. Lots of love, dog. I appreciate that, bro. I love you too, dog. Let's do it again because I messed it up. There we go. And then, dope. You get a handy. Get a handy. Handy, 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 mandy, pandy. Oh. Yeah, so we were just fucking talking about the world being at fucking WARR. And WARR! You don't like the hologram? I like it. It's like I'm coming out of the fire. My face is a hologram. Looking like Ghost Rider up in this bitch. Up in this bitch. Up in this bitch. Up in this bitch.
Ha ha.
I don't know, bro. I'm kind of feeling the hologram. You know, I'm like, I'm bursting out of the flames of a UFC. It looks like, nutty, like the pick of a UFC cage fighter.
I am decimation. I see you.
That's it, bro. This means WARR. Look like in this corner we have the burning bush, the Messiah, the speaker of Yahweh, and in this corner the old man fainting. Ha ha ha! This means WARR, bro. You gotta duel me back, bro. You gotta hit I accept. Actually, I made it fucking. I made it so you can't. So you can't fucking. Oh, I won the duel, bitch. I made it so you can't deny it, right? I turned off the deny option. So if somebody duels, you have to press. You have to type exclamation point duel and then space at the username. I mean, you'll get it. So, like, if I want to fucking. Oh, it didn't type, damn it. Ah, damn it. So now if I go like this, I duel at KDN823. Oh, I'm already dueling. See, you can only duel one person at once, but I made it so it's no limit. So you could just consistently duel people. Oh, God. So, I don't know, bro. You're not feeling the... You're not feeling the light? You duel sound alerts, you can't duel, you can't, first of all, you spelled it wrong. Second of all, you can't duel the bot. Can't duel the bot, my friend. You can't duel the bot, 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 bot. Oh, you can. Well, I'm going to turn it off. No, you have to press exclamation point accept, Kyle. You already lost. If you don't respond within 2 minutes, you lose. You lose the duel, bro. You lost the duel. You don't do what you want, bro. You do what I tell you, bro. D-Rock, you have to cancel your duel. No, I can't duel you again. You have to press exclamation point accept. I can't. You have to accept it. You can't do a double duel. No, fucking dab won't do you. I think it's too late. You lost the duel. You can't. The bot won't respond, bro. I canceled your duel. I accept. Boom, bitch. Get out the way. Get out the way, bitch. Get out the way. Alright, alright. One more time. It's mad fun, right? I knew it would be fun. Just like this.
Smoke weed every day.
You can't duel the fucking bot. D-Rock, cancel your fucking bot. Yo, don't hate on the bot, bro. The bot is gangsta. And I upped the fucking time for you, but if you would stop fucking trying to duel the bot, there would be less bot messages. If you literally stop doing it. No. Can you cancel the duel, please, and stop dueling the bot so I don't have to turn it off? Because it's a fun thing to do when you're not a douche. No. Can't do that. You can't do that, bro. Yo, if you don't cancel it, I'm gonna turn that off. You can't. It automatically turns off after 2 minutes, and you don't beat him. It just stops. Which means the stream elements beat you because you can't beat it. So that means stream elements is tougher than you. Just like Batman. Batman's tougher than you too. You know what I'm saying? But you can't take it from me. You could take it from...
Hey, yo. This is Cece from Pressure Boys, the best smoke on the East Coast. And you're watching the WARR Multiverse. Sheesh.
Ugh. He's not in here. It won't let you duel them if they're not in the chat. Obviously not. You can't beat stream elements. Say you can't find the user. You can duel Alexander Hamilton. See, if you're getting annoyed about stream elements, you're the one who's bringing up some more stream elements. And you can't duel yourself, dingling. You see that face it gives you, you fucking dingbat? Because that's suicide, you fucking dingbat. You can duel that. It's funny, I have the chat open on Discord and all these messages are on Discord. Feel like you could win what? Alexander Hamilton? I don't know, why do you want to win Alexander Hamilton's heart? What are you fucking... You in love with him, bro? You in love with Alexander Hamilton? Oh, a duel with yourself? You want suicide? Yeah, well, suicide's no good, bro. But don't take it from me. Take it from...
Hey, yo, this is Cece from Pressure Boys, the best smoke on the East Coast. And you're watching the WARR Multiverse. Sheesh!
Nope, too late. I already did it. In fact, I should turn that into a command. But when I make it a command, only moderators can use those commands. Only the dueling command you could do. Sheesh! The best smoke on the East Coast. Sheesh! The best high on the L.I. Sheesh! But don't take it from me, the burning bush. Take it from...
Hey, yo, this is Cece from Pressure Boys, the best smoke on the East Coast. And you're watching the WARR Multiverse. Sheesh!
Alright. Now that we had a little fun, we're going to get back into this talk now. So the entire world is at war, and right now what we're seeing is a rise in totalitarianism. And the... I lurk. Yeah, fuck you. Gave you a shout out and everything, man. What, do you gotta go walk the dog, man? What, do you gotta go beat the meat, man? Huh? Huh? What, are you playing Rocket League, man? Yeah, tell fucking Trevin I said hello. Tell him I said his mother says hi. Gotta comb through my text messages and Facebook messages between me and Di's mom. The mom? Oh yeah, cause tomorrow you biznay. That's right. I was thinking of Trevin. Yeah, you would be thinking of Trevin, bro. I think you like Trevin, bro. You like Trevin more than Alexander Hamilton. And... I'm blushing. Yes, I knew it. Boom, bitch. That's 2 wins in a row, son. Take this.
Oh, yes, daddy.
Get slapped like fucking that. How do you even win the duels, bro? Bro, the fucking bot decides to win the duel. So it goes by however fast you answer. That audio is mad loud, OMG. Yeah, I know, bro. Wake the fuck up. Get the fucking wake up, bro. You wanna do me again? How high I am. Oh, I should make that a command too. It's ear rapey. Your face is ear rapey. Spelt it wrong. I won again, bitch. I'm the fucking king, bro. Yeah, I don't know, bro. It didn't make sense either, but that's what came out of my mouth. You know, so fucking take this.
We did it.
Fist bump, bro. Fist bump. So yeah, so tonight, those of you who are in the Discord link is in the chat, and it's also in the fucking, it's also right there on your fucking screen, and you fucking join in on the Discord, and we're watching fucking Transformers, what, the third one now, is it tonight? I smoke a bowl with KDN. Alright, bro, you know what, you want me to make all these commands? You want to be my mod, bro? Like, come on, bro. This shit is rigged, bro. I think this shit is rigged. Alright, bro, here, I'll duel you this time, and we'll see. Don Jed! Boom, I won again, bro. What is good? Don Jed the Donnie boy.
It's good.
What up, kitty?
I'm just scared. I love me.
Love you too, bro. Love that fucking kitty, bro. I got three kitties too. Yo, you have to type in I accept to accept the duel, and you can't click I deny. Ah, damn, I won that one, bro. Alright, bro, so you're 1-for-5. We're good. You have to click I accept within 2 minutes to win the duel, bro. Oh shit. Did he win? Who won? Oh. Yeah, you took the dive to prove, make it seem like it's not rigged. Bro, I'm not doing anything, bro. All I do is type in either I duel in the username or I accept the same as you, bro. That's it. Ah, you forgot the T, bro. Oh, D-Rock won the duel, son. He won the duel, son. Yo, Don Jed, you like my burning bush face right here? Coming out of the thing? Stream Elements rigged it. Smoke a blunt, bro. I'm already smoking, bro. I don't even stop smoking, bro. It gave me a good laugh. Yeah, literally.
Smoke weed every day.
What was it? Wasn't it Alexander Hamilton? No, I mean, not Alexander Hamilton. What the fuck is his other name? Thomas? No, not Jefferson. Man, I'm not fighting no more. Teddy Roosevelt, that's right. Sounds more right. So we're talking about the whole fucking world being at war, bro, and how everybody's separating and isolating. The point is that we're building up to is that there's no way it was Teddy, bro. I don't know, I forget. I honestly forget who it was. Andrew, yeah, Andrew Jackson, that's who I'm fucking thinking of. That's who I was trying to think of the whole time. I said Alexander Hamilton instead of Andrew Jackson. That's fucking right. That's definitely right. It sounds right. So we're talking about the whole fucking world being at war. So one of the things that I fucking notice about everything is that most duels ended in both living because the gun's aim were so shit. Yo, it's not only that, bro. Yo, I'm gonna show you real quick on my fucking. I'm gonna fucking show you real quick on this. Look at this. Who would I be if I never... That's mad loud too. Yo, so they used to go like this, right? When you would point the gun at the person, at the end of the duel, they would shoot it up, right? And you would see that, like, they did that with fucking, in the Hamilton play, right? And, yeah. So, yeah, he was in duels. So they did that in the Hamilton play, right? And that's what they would do, because in the last minute, it meant to be like you were showing honor, you were showing mercy. You know, they would duel like that. You know, and that's how you showed your honor, was, you know, you showed mercy at the end. You were an honorable man, you know. So they would do that, and you would... Can't find that user, bro. Can't find that user. So you would fight everybody and honor this dick. I'm shooting second because I'm aim. Yo, fact though. Fact. You're fucking dodging that shit like fucking Morpheus, bro. You're in the Matrix, bro. That's what you are. You're in the fucking Matrix, bro. Just like me with this hologram head over here, bro, hiding in the burning bush. If they shoot at me, they gotta die. Well, I thought it was if they shoot at you, then you die first, and then that way you can't get revenge. You know? Boom! They want you dead, bro. Why? Who wants you dead already, bro? Challenge me to a duel, and on God, the clip is gonna empty. Don't you mean on your omnipotent lord, the burning bush? That's what you mean. Nope, I can't have nobody breathing, walking around, wanting me dead or alive. You know? Alright, dead? That's 500. How about alive? You know what I noticed? People are only as threatening as they seem. Damn, bro, you gotta do it again, bro, to fucking win the duel, bro. Hit the challenge. Challenge him, bro. I feel like you're gonna win this time. I know you're gonna win this time, bro. You can't fucking win that shit, yo. Spins the gun and blows the smoke off the barrel. Yes, and then puts it right back into your holster. Yes, I think that was more of a Western thing, but they did have smoke on barrels in those days. I wouldn't duel back in the day, I'd be a slave. Oh, God. That's, it's like not really funny, but... Nah, dog, Django that shit. Yeah, dog. Fucking Django that shit, bro. Whee! Well, I mean, it is not really funny, but, like, what are you gonna do? Not laugh about it now, you know? Like, it's fucking... You know, I mean, obviously I don't fucking approve of that shit at all, but in any sense of the way, but, like, you know... The way it was put in this situation is, yeah, dark humor, exactly. That's what it is, to sum it all up. And, to fucking sum it all up. And, you know, we're talking about over here, you know, summing up the fucking world being at war. You know, everybody is at fucking war because we're starting to see the divide between East and West. You know, I don't know if you guys ever watched this show on fucking HBO Max called Raised by Wolves. When I tell people my real name, I tell them it's my slave name. That's funny. Do you see his spooky ghost face in the burning bush? Woo! Woo! Okay, I see my guardian angel. That's right, bro. That's right, bro. I am your guardian angel speaking to you through this hologram burning bush. You know? And I am the burning bush. And this is war. Oh, God. I hope not. Yeah, well, your mom hopes her bush ain't burning either. Oh, got him. Oh, hilarious. So, fucking, so if you ever seen that movie Raised by Wolves, but in that movie, you know, I mean, a TV show, it's about, when she done with you, both of your bushes are burning. Oh, what is she, a redhead? Oh, 2-for-1 stone. Oh, need to get that special shampoo. Bro, let me tell you something, bro. I have been using the same shampoo and conditioner every single time I've showered for like fucking 30 years. However old I am, that's how long I've been using it. I've been using it since I was like 8, to be precise, probably. In their den getting body lice. Yeah, no, I'm not getting that, you savage. I've been using the same hair, bro. My fucking hair is fucking soft as a fucking fluffy sheep. And fucking rolling around buried your bush. Yeah. Burning your bush. Yeah, I'm over here burning my bush over here. And I've been getting my hair cut from the same guy for 13 years. So, you know, it's very fucking precise over here, you know. You know, I know I fucking look good, but it takes not that much to look this good, you know, because I'm born with it. Oh, get it? Oh, you fucking got it over here. Same barber for 13 years, bro. Yeah. You know what I'm saying? You know what I'm saying. Boom! Boom! He did. Maybe it's Maybelline. Yeah, maybe it is Maybelline. You don't know. It could be Maybelline. It could be your face. Yeah. So, if you watch that show, though, in the future, it's about how the whole world is divided in half. One side is technological advancement and democracy. And the other side is totalitarian religious rule. Totalitarian and religious rule, I should say. Right? So, and it's literally East versus West, right? Well, in this show, the humans who are on the technology side lose the battle. Right? But in the course of the battle, they fight a big war and also destroy the planet. So they go off to this distant planet that they think is like half dead, but they have an ability to terraform to the planet, right? But it's got breathable oxygen and stuff. So they only know what's going on in like this little like wolf's den of a circle that they live in, right? And all of a sudden the fucking guys from the west, from the east, who are the religious totalitarians, come to the same planet, and then they're fighting each other again. Well, alone do you know that life on this planet might or might not really be dead. You know, and there could be like some fucking demon souls and shit and everything, and there's these crazy creatures down there, bro. It's fucking crazy. But I thought it was so insane because, you know, the entire world is at war in that thing, in a similar fashion to how we are today, with our fighting East versus West. I mean, we literally are referring to it as that in our news shows and all our different different news shows and all different podcasts and books and everything. I mean, people are really referring to it as a war of East versus West, as a war of, you know, not only East versus West, but good versus evil. You hear Biden say that all the time. You know, you hear Biden say all the time that, you know, it's a war versus good or evil, and they're evil. You hear Volodymyr say that all the time. It's a war versus good and evil. You know, and there we go. And so, you know, you have all these parallels both through history, fantasy of the future, mythology, religion, and current life, aka the present time that we live in. You see all these parallels together. Everybody winning together. And wow, bro, you're gonna automatically lose the duel, bro. So you have everybody fighting for the same thing on the same side, but the problem is our world doesn't even seem to be like that right now. Our world seems to be that we are like splitting into fours. You have, you know, both hemispheres splitting in half, which would split the Earth into four sections, you know, east and west of both the north and the south, you know, and that's really what's happening over here. You know, you have all these countries in the south who are fighting for starvation. Boom, bro, you took way too fucking long to accept that shit. What are you fucking working, bro? What, you got a job, bro? You're a fucking douche, bro. Go home, bro. Get out of your job, bro. I ain't got no job, bro. Just kidding, bro. This is my job, and writing is my job, and fucking working is my job. Working shit every fucking day. It's gonna bring me to my last fucking point. But first, we're splitting into fours. Now keep that in mind while we take a quick fucking water break. Why is Clippy lagging? Fuck you, Clippy.
Superman!
Oh my god!
The only thing that can kill me is kryptonite, or latex, or lambskin.
What about polyurethane?
All that stuff. We now return to Superman.
Lois, what's wrong?
Clark, we all have breast cancer!
The doctor says it's as if our breasts have been x-rayed 5 hours a day, every day for the last 3 years.
Oh my god, that's terrible. First every woman I've ever known, and now you guys.
God, I'm sick of Mort always borrowing our stuff. He's a bigger mooch than the Mexican Super Friends.
Hey, Mexican Superman, can I talk to you for a sec? When you signed the lease, you said there was going to be like five of you living here.
Oh, no, they're not all living here. They're just visiting.
Hey, Mexican Superman, I got the...
Goodbye.
All right, that was like seven goodbye jokes.
Oh, you are so ugly!
Oh my god, that was another racist thing.
What the fuck is a Hello Kitty?
Bombay Sapphire, that's right.
So old.
That was good.
She sat next to Moses in third grade. Let my trapper keeper go. Your mama's so fat. She doesn't need internet. She's already worldwide.
Okay, that
That's
was good.
That's a huge bitch. Your mom is so stupid. She studied for a drug test by taking all of the drugs.
Me.
And we're back. That was a good water break. Yeah. You fucking... That's right. And as soon as we're done with this show will be uploaded as a podcast. So, person possibly named Kyle and D-Rock, everybody's gonna hear me verbalize your dueling, bitch, because you can't even duel, bro. You don't even know how to duel, bro. You know what I'm saying, bro? You know what I'm saying, G? She'd like us some chocolate. So before the quick little break over there, the quick little water break that we took, real quick, we were just mentioning how the world is splitting in half. But then I said it seems to be more like it's splitting in fours. Because if you talk about the southern hemisphere, you know, you have a lot of the southern hemisphere either still believes in polytheism or polytheistic versions of the current, what should I call it? The current version of their Christian beliefs that they've taken into whatever it be, like in a lot of South American cultures, you know? Because if you go down to South America or you watch a documentary or an Ancient Aliens episode, you know, you go there and there are still people who practice the old ways, the old polytheistic religions. You know, and or believe in them as being, it's like they combine the two. They combine Christianity as well as their religion. You know, it's not separate like how we identify it in the North, you know, and in the Northwest, I should say, because we're talking about everything splitting into fours now. Same thing, India still believes in majority Hinduism. And that's a polytheistic religion, and it's also the oldest known religion on the planet that still exists. You know, and then you have Buddhism, and that's a polytheistic religion that also has a combination of it as the being saints, you know. So those sides are kind of meshing, and that's why Buddhism and Hinduism doesn't really fight, because they pretty much believe in most of the same things, and so they don't really fight together. So you have all these separate areas, you know, dividing off from each other. You even have, you know, the islands of Japan isolating from the Eastern Asia over there, because they're, you know, separate from all the issues that are going on with China's mainland and Russia's war as well, you know. And Russia's a huge country, you know, they span 11 time zones. It takes a lot to maintain and manage that you know, vast amount of space. You know, so you have all these different areas, and now you have the two north. So we'll, you know, we'll say that the southern hemisphere cuts off at around India. You know the southern eastern hemisphere, if we're cutting it into fours, blasts off into fucking you know, so. The whole world is, so in the beginning of the conversation I spoke about how, you know, in the past we're seeing a similar revitalization of thoughts that people had 100 years ago, you know, early 1900s to now, you know, to late 1900s, you know, to the 1920s, you know, just like now, you know, we're in the 2020s now, it's 100 years later, and yet we're having some of the same thoughts as they used to have. You know, even today you're seeing a rise in anti-Semitism in Poland, in other parts of Eastern Europe. You know, I mean, we know this now because, you know, then Russia's claiming that they're fighting against Nazism and Semitism, you know. So whether it's true or not is not the point. The point is that it's a problem for both the truth speakers and the liars. You know, it's either way, it's a problem for those people. You know, whether you're telling the truth about it being a real thing or you're lying about it being a real thing, it's still a problem. And that's the point here. You know, and but that's not only why, you know, on the massive scale, we also have individuals on a scale, and you don't got to even point to Europe, point to this country. You know, we have a rise in hate crimes all across the board. You know, here in New York, you know, we just had that kid in Buffalo, you know, and he posted for days and months that he was going to kill black people, you know, because black people were taken over. I mean, it's right there in your face, you know, and so, you know, just like I'm right here in your face, but you could only partly see it because we're a hologram projection through the burning bush now. Later on, I'm going to probably remake this whole screen because now that I like this fucking hologram feature, but D-Rock says it looks like I'm coming in about to announce myself into a fucking ring, you know, where I'm coming in for WWE, you know, and I'm in the ring, and this is the WARR multiverse in the ring. And in this corner, we have WARR multiverse. And in this corner, we have the Mad D-Rock for the duel, and he can't win. Because he's out beating the meat. Oh, I see what happens, bro. You fucking took a step out. You says, I gotta go pick up a phone call, you know? Nah, I know he's busy. I'm just fucking with him. I know he's busy. He's got fucking a bunch of shit going on this week. Yeah, what? It says you're not in here, bro. Well, I'm gonna do it again. Let's try and do it again. You spelled my name wrong, you buffoon. Yeah, well, fuck you, you buffoon, you know? What are you gonna do about it? Oh, I friggin' won, bro. Let's get it. Yeah, I fucking won that shit, bro. That's what you get. That's what you get for making me spell your name wrong. So I said, it's your fault. You typed the mad duel, bro. Yeah, bro, that's because I'm fucking angry for the duel, bro. I'm fucking mad, bro. Can't you see me coming out of the flames, bro? Nah, don't change your name. I'm just fucking with you. I'm just messing around, bro. I'm just chilling, bro. But don't... Yeah, you can't duel somebody who's not in the chat, bro. Pressure boys aren't in the chat, bro. Multiverse, look at this BS. Yo, that's what I'm saying, bro. Look at this BS, bro. I'm like the fire in the chat, bro. I'm on fire. I'm on fire. T-Rock, you can't duel yourself again, bro. But yeah, but don't take it from me. Take it from... I didn't have it queued up.
Hey, yo, this is CeCe from Pressure Boys, the best smoke on the East Coast, and you're watching the WARR multiverse. Sheesh!
You just want to duel yourself before family court? But that would be suicide, bro. You know what I'm going to do? I'm gonna make a command that's D-Rog duels himself, and then it's just going to be a hangman guy hanging himself. The image is just going to pop up. That's what I'm going to get. That's what it's going to be next time. And I'll make it available for everybody. I duel D-Rock's bitch baby mom. Oh, that's not good for mental health, bro. Yeah, well, you know what? If you do want help with mental health, we could talk about that another time. Or you can message me in the thing. What is up, living dream? It's the dream. What up? How are you? How you doing today? You know, you saying over here? Oh, living dead. I'm freaking retarded. I can't even see, bro. Living dead man is lit. I'm fucking lying, bro. What up, dead man? How you doing? Living dead man is lit, bro. Either way, I'm going to be dueling her at some point, whether it's here or on the accounting plan. Cause they lit, bro. So then, they fucking lit. Everybody's lit, bro. So then, whoa, what the fuck just happened there? Oh shit, my shit zoomed in, bro. Oh my god, I can't even see it now. You just want the court that I have given more time and the primary guardian. Bro, you should be the primary guardian. Yo, how did it double zoom on this shit? I don't even understand how I did that. Oh, the normal way you zoom, I guess. That's it. I mean, that's what she is trying to do anyway. Yo, bro, listen, man. Listen. You got the kid all the time, man. I see you with the kid. You're great with the kid. He fucking loves you. And you love him. He's a good kid, too. I've seen him on here. You want to see him on here? We got multiple clips, bro. Bro, you know what? Everybody's got to go about their shit their own freaking way and be either mean to people or, you know, they got to hurt the ones that they love, you know, because people don't even realize, you know, she's not only doing it to you, but she's doing it to the kid. I mean, what, the kid's either got to come with you or she's got to, but it's family court, so the kid's got to be there. You know, I mean, you know, the kid should be out fucking playing outside. It's going to be beautiful out tomorrow. You know, after this today, I'm going to go fly the drone around and fucking have fun messing with it because I haven't flown it around since like last year and I need to do it again because I want to use it for filming something that we're doing that you guys will be able to see once it's done. Hopefully it'll be done quick because then I'll mess with it and get it done and it can be ready for fucking Wednesday if we get it done quick this weekend, if we have time. I know I have time one of these nights to go out and film it. I'm putting it on the calendar. Today I'm fucking busy as shit, but I gotta fucking mess with it. Yeah, I gotta fucking mess with it. You know what I'm saying?
Do it!
Just
do it!
Just fucking do it. You know what I'm saying? Listen to your Lord over here. Listen to your burning bush over here. You know, because we're fucking chilling over here, and the burning bush knows all. You want to host my morning meditation tomorrow at 10 a.m.? Or should we just skip her? I think we're just going to skip her, bro, because I'm getting the feeling that I'm not going to get to be flying the drone today, and then the only other time I would have to do that would be tomorrow morning. So I'm hoping that I can get to do that tomorrow morning. So I think we should just
skip. Oh, yes, Daddy!
Huh? Mm-hmm. Somebody just figured out how to play him. Living Dead Man. Dead Man played it. Yes, no diggity, no doubt. Oh, diggity, no doubt. Yeah, D-Rock was complaining about the noise before, so I'll lower the volume on this one. Oh, it didn't go. What happened there? Didn't go again. Oh, there we go. Maybe it'll go twice now. No diggity, no doubt. Yeah, it went twice now. Sweet. Yeah. I like that one. That's a nice wake-up call. You know, should I do... Maybe if I do meditation, instead of it having, like, be like a dong, I'm just going to wake everybody up with that. You know, imagine that.
Your dick's small.
Your dick's small. Yeah. Yo, I love it. I love it. I love it. It's so much funnier with Adam Sandler there and the milk is fucking drooling down his face. Nah, no more meditation, bro. I'm gonna fucking... I got a lot of shit to do, and I gotta finish this, I gotta finish this book that's coming out, and I gotta finish, getting the fucking... I gotta set up for this fucking, podcast today. Gotta make sure I'm set to go on all the fucking news, on Saturday. Tomorrow, also, if I'm around at night, I wanna fucking game up and just chill, because, fucking... I figured out how to, I fixed this controller and shit, so now we can game up and play all different games. And I wanna fucking game up and chill with that. So we'll game... I wanna game up tomorrow night. And then, Saturday, we're having the fucking win, and then cartoons with you. Today, I got a meeting at 3 o'clock. So I can't fucking, got business meeting at 3 o'clock. I love it, bro. I love it. I love it. I love it, bro. Fucking hilarious. So I got a meeting at 3 o'clock today. And then we got Transformers at 5. So I got a meeting from 3 to 4. We got Transformers at 5. And then... So there's like no time to fucking do the drone today, because in between that I gotta do all my other shit. 3 o'clock. Yeah, it's fucking 3 o'clock over here, you know what I'm saying? And you know, and then I gotta fucking tell Tony and Paulie 3 o'clock. What time did we whack the guy? I don't know. You were there, weren't you? Oh, God. So then fucking... So we got a lot of shit going on this weekend. We're going to have a lot to talk about on fucking Saturday morning at 9 o'clock. We're going to have a lot to talk about. And then tomorrow, I got other shit to do on my calendar tomorrow. I just don't fucking remember what it is because there's just so much shit going on. And I know that there's something else I have to do too. You know, that's just the point. I write everything down. Oh, that's what I got to do. I got to send this mad fucking important email. Has to be done right after this. I'm going to do it while the audio is translating for it. You want to write it down too? Write what down? Your ass? You want to write down your ass too? You want to write down Weston's face is sexy in this burning bush? Lord Commander's face is sexy in this burning bush? He who is weird is burning his bush? Oh my God.
Smoke weed every day.
Oh, okay.
Smoke weed every day.
How stoned am I? Well, this joint's almost done. You know, we're having fun. We're having a great fucking time, bro. You know, we're chilling in here. Yeah, see, bro? You know, yo, just keep playing them all, bro. Play them all. Play them all. Yeah, super fucking stoned. That's why we fucking talk about this shit, bro. We gotta talk about the world, man. We're talking about the world at war again. See, the title is World at War 2, but we're not referring to World War 2. We're referring to World at War again. Being the second time. Where even though it's not really the second time, it's more like the second billionth time. Stream, son, before I get started. Want to smoke a bowl quick before I get started? Fuck yeah, bro. What time you going on? I got about 15 minutes on here, bro. Got about 15 minutes left on here. Why don't you just smoke a bowl now, bro? Smoke a bowl with us, bro, right now. You know, and here, I'll play it again for you.
Smoke weed every day.
You'll be in Dank Sinatra. Do I have one of those in here? So we can hear it in the stream. Get in the fucking... get in the... Go to the WARR multiverse, or just go to your Game Together channel. If you're already in the fucking Dank Sinatra one, go to the Game Together channel. Let me log back in. Let me open up the Discord app, because I think I have to have it open. Which I fixed it, by the way, D-Rock, so now we can hear sounds without having me change the audio, too.
There we go. He's up in here.
Up in this, up in that, up in crack.
Yeah, you got it, man. Who's popping, son?
What?
Looking like a goddamn Greek god, you know what I mean? Like I just came out of motherfucking Italy.
Hey,
yeah, I just came out of the burning bush over here, you know, when I was with your sister last night, my bush started burning over here.
Yeah, that was a burning bush. I felt that one myself.
From his burning bush over here, this fucking monkey pox getting some of it.
This fucking guy over here.
Fucking Goomba of a man.
Fucking Goomba. Goombadre and Goombadre, you know what I'm saying?
This fucking...
I'm gonna, go grab the bong and some pants. Hold up. Oh, my camera turned back on.
You gotta watch for that touch to click, bro.
You gotta watch.
I don't want you to see my clitoris.
Hey, yo, listen over here.
Hey, yo, this fucking guy.
This fucking guy. Hey, this fucking stop of the movie. This fucking boobada bobada schmabada boobada.
And beebity bobbity booby.
Yeah, this scheme of the rockada. This rockada scheme of the.
Peter, just because you grew a mustache doesn't mean you can know how to speak Italian.
Yes, it does, actually.
That's
you know what's
happened,
funny?
Bro.
You want to know what's really funny? Is I took
fucking tell me this funny thing. Don't tell me, do you want to know, do you want to know? I'm not six, all right? Yes, I want to know the funny thing. Let me know.
I fucking...
Want to hear something funny?
Want to hear something funny?
Yeah. Yeah, please.
I took Italian in high school and middle school and college, and yeah. I understand it completely, but when I go to speak back in conversation, I cannot say a fucking word, bro. I can't. Yeah. I understand everything they say to me totally perfectly, cannot say anything back.
You know what my favorite is that there's an Italian restaurant named Buca di Beppo. It's just fucking funny. Hey, Buca di Beppo!
Capricci. Hey,
book in
the back
with
a
bop in the back of the...
What are you doing?
I'm walking here.
Hey, what are you doing over here and there? You know what I mean?
Smoke weed every day.
Yeah, over there.
Over here.
Bring it over here.
Smoke weed every day. Best coffee in the world over here. You know what I'm saying?
How fuck we don't have a hand in this Starbucks? I mean, we made this shit.
Shit,
cheers, gang.
Yeah, yeah. Gang,
gang. Gang. Cheers. For those of you who are out there and you're not knowing what we're doing, we're smoking. So, just fucking
do it!
Just do it.
Just
do it!
Just fucking
do it,
fucking bro. Do it. And then after
smoke
you did it,
weed.
You could say that we did it.
We did it.
Yo, that little chat shit with, was it Snakes? Games with Snakes? Last night? That was fucking mad fun.
Oh, yeah, that was hilarious, bro.
I was trying to keep up in the chat, but I was like, nah, man, fucking gods and aliens and all that shit. I got you, bro. I know what it is. I know what it is.
I know all about it. I was like, I kept messaging. I was like, I know everything about aliens.
I've been smoking since I was 14,
you know,
man. Thought about it. You know what I'm saying?
Yo, fat.
Yeah, it was some good conversations though, man. I had a crazy ass dream.
You know why I know that the fucking aliens exist? Because I've seen it, bro. I've been there.
You seen it with your own two eyes?
My own two eyes, bro. I lived it. I was an alien.
Yeah, I came from Mexico myself.
War Multiverse was Will Smith. He just had a fucking cigar in his mouth, just punching out illegal aliens everywhere he could.
Like,
let's
right
go
here
to Home Depot real quick. We're gonna fight.
Yo, I swear to God, when that fuck... I mean, swear to me, because I'm the burning bush. I swear, bro, when the fucking COVID first came out, the first thing I started referencing was fucking the Will Smith's movie, I Am Legend.
Yeah, yeah.
Fucking thing. And then all of a sudden everybody was referencing that. They were like, oh, it's like that movie. And I was like, did I like unintentionally start something? Or did anybody else have the same thought as me? Probably the same thought as me.
Well, that movie was like made off of like two other movies that came before it and a book that was written called The Omega Man.
I did actually hear that recently. That's cool.
I
didn't know what book it was
called.
Omega Man.
Omega
they have
Man.
An Audible version of that. Let's find out.
They probably do, you little silly dude.
My Audible subscription renews.
Dude, are you wearing two fucking watches like Data from the Goonies over here, bro? What is
this? This one is the OnePlus watch for my phone.
I have my OnePlus phone. This is like my daily life. This
and the used other to one, like, measures your boners?
This used to be my old watch, but now I'm using it just for, like, multiverse shit. For when the Discord pops up. So I don't have to have notifications. I can still get all my notifications on my watch, and then I can choose whether I have to respond to them or not. Which I usually don't respond to them. Especially on
now,
this
let me
show.
See on this show. Let me see your other arm. Why is there? Why do you have a watch like, arm?
He lifts up a nub. He's like, I don't have another arm.
Yeah, no other arm, bro.
Just I don't want to look at my fucking bicep every time I need to check the time.
Yeah, let me just go over.
Oh, I don't know. I'm a nut. I'd have one on each watch. I feel unbalanced. You know what I'm saying?
No, let me tell you, it's not even that. The problem is, put a watch on your wrist and put it, when the smartwatches, you're supposed to keep them, like, snug, like, to the skin almost, but not tight, just snug. And
yes,
when you have that on both hands,
heartbeat and stuff.
Right. And when you have that on both hands for long periods of time, it feels like you're wearing, like, almost handcuffs all the time. So I figure, keep my right hand, my dominant hand, free. It's the martial artist in me, bro. It's
I was gonna say, he likes to sit on his left arm, and as soon as it has the two watches, it's like a different weight.
He tightens up the two on his left hand really tight.
Oh, bro, what do you mean, bro?
That's off the circulation.
I'm fucking, I got
there's a ghost in here with me. It's aliens beating me off.
He's like, and this is the Samsung watch? And this is
this is my fucking Apple Watch right here. I choked myself with that.
It's got a big Flavor Flav clock.
This is one of my tablets.
Yeah.
I got like a million other things. I
got. Like I got Pornhub queued and surround sound and five different tablets.
Bro,
like,
I got. Bro, titties. It's all right, fucking. Facial.
All right.
Remember what was it on your stream? I coined the term Quadra Sound. Because I got Quadra. Sound coming out of, I got four sources, I got the two TVs, and then it comes out of the two subwoofer speakers, the sound bars, just fucking blasting, bro. Whenever I listen to music, bro, my fucking neighbors hate the shit out of me.
I got the fucking, since I do the studio shit, nice. I'm blasting my shit, bro.
Blasting.
I can when I
Yo,
take out my press,
nice
I still hear it.
Bro, that's what I need in here is a nice fan. I had this fan
a
and
fan?
It fucking vanished. Yeah, like I had like a regular fan, you know, like put on like a desktop or whatever, and that fucking shit like is literally gone. Nobody knows where it is. I searched the entire fucking house. It's gone.
Yo, this is what you need to get, bro. It's like I got like three of them. $10, bro.
You need, someone God. Opened that window and said,
"Yeah, just went fling."
You go 1, 2, 3. You got it's got three speeds.
Oh, is that the thing that was making all that noise on your stream the other
it,
night?
Fold it in half. No, this wasn't making noise on my stream. What are you?
That's for his gooch.
You had the fan on the other night, and I was like, "What is that background noise?"
I got a
like,
fan. I got an air conditioner. I'm fucking the king of cool over
You're
here,
the
dog.
King of cool. I'm fucking Miles Davis.
Hey,
Miles Davis.
Well, fucking peeing your pants is cool. Then I'd be Miles Davis.
Wow.
Oh, do you remember that Adam Sandler movie? Billy Madison.
Ah,
I love that one.
It's like, I had an accident, and he fucking sprays water on his pants. So everybody's like, oh, look, Billy peed his pants. He's like, yeah, dude, because peeing your pants is cool. All the cool kids are peeing their pants. Right? And then this old lady looks at him. She's like, if peeing your pants is cool, then I must be Miles Davis. And he's like, that's the grossest thing I've ever heard. Like,
yeah, I love Adam Sandler's little stupid.
Yo, know, my cousin died a couple of years back, and I was really fucked up over it, because he was my little cousin. He was like 29 years old when he died, bro. Fucking,
nice
Scooby Halloween.
Nice fan message, by the way, bro.
Yeah. Fan, I said your fan was a taint fan.
It was a tank fan?
A taint,
fan.
Yeah.
Little tiny
okay.
little
you put
little
it you put
little,
it right in your
yeah.
and
you're
fucking
looking
right
up
and right
yeah.
in there. Yeah. It hits the valley, all the regions,
that's
it folds
what all the
up nice
basketball players do, bro.
Fuck yeah, bro. You ever just take a bath with your fucking legs up like that and you're like, yeah, you got three fans, surround air. It's got three speeds. You know what I'm saying?
Yo, I hope you guys know that I don't cut anything or edit anything, so this is all going to be on the podcast.
Yeah, shout out to the podcast. I'll show you the maneuver. You got to get both legs.
You throw one leg behind that ear.
That's why I've been doing that yoga lately. You got to get those stretches in, you know what I'm saying? So the fan will hit the right spot.
You know what I'm saying?
Monday morning in meditation, Tuesday taint fanning.
That's right.
Well, we manifest more air and surround flow for the taint. That comes out like 11.
That should be.
Because at 11 noon, that's when it gets really hot and you definitely want to. Some people have hot tubs, I have hot taints. You know what I'm saying?
Somebody likes a tea bag, I like a taint bag. You know what I'm saying? Yeah,
that's right. It's just a different kind of tea bag, you know what I'm saying?
It's just a different kind of tea
bag. Be careful, those blades, though, you know what I'm saying? You gotta be a professional.
Wait, we gotta get back to Adam Sandler, dog.
That's one thing, but if you go in there, you know, you don't want to fucking make your nudes, you know?
A little Mika Maka.
A patooter.
Hey, a little Maka to Mika to.
Fucking Bacala.
Yeah, let me see a little Nicky.
A little Nicky?
A little Nicky.
Fucking shovel face.
The guy has boobs on his head.
Popeye's chicken is the shizness.
I had Popeye's for the first time a few months ago.
Oh, it's not bad. It's not bad.
It's not bad.
I've never had Popeye's.
It's better than I'll say it's better than KFC, like hands down.
I like KFC.
I would say they're chicken sandwiches for sure.
Oh, death.
Oh yeah.
What's
I don't know. I haven't had it. I can't.
Turkey chicken.
I didn't see it, so it doesn't exist.
Yo, they got some dry ass. I feel like no matter where you go, you get that dry ass biscuit though. Like holy shit, bro.
Yeah.
I take like half of the honey and put it on the chicken skin. The other half of the honey on those dry ass biscuits. I'm like,
oh, see, bro. You gotta get the biggest fucking drink. Save them for later. You pop them in the fucking toaster oven on like a bake for a little bit, bro. About 350.
Come on, bro. You just gotta throw them through some house window.
Bro, you take some fucking garlic powder, some cheese. Fucking melt that shit on there. A little oregano.
If I wanted to make dinner, I wouldn't be going to Popeye's, I guess.
Bro, he said you take some oregano, some cheese.
I was making dinner, bro. Fucking have a
fucking
feast.
Little brazulto.
Little fucking
said,
dog.
That's why I never cook.
Pecorino Romano, goat cheese on that bitch.
Hey,
you want to get
some nice
Romano fucking.
On there, a little pasta fragile on the side.
There you go, let it get stuck to my fingers.
Pasta padan.
Some sazon on that chicken, you know what I mean? Some adobo.
Yo, you know what's mad funny? I actually think I have right over here, I have the Sopranos cookbook.
Oh, wow.
Really?
Yeah, let me see. Hold on. Yeah, it's right here. It's right here. This is I got this as a Christmas gift one year.
Oh God.
The Sopranos.
Does anybody else's watch yell at him like, "Yo, you got to
get up. You gotta get Buko."
Really?
That's what it says. New York Times bestseller, written by Alan Ruker, recipes by Michelle Sicilione.
Sicilione
and series created by David Chase, of course, the Don. The Godfather, the real fucking OG motherfucker.
Oh, wow.
What do I have? I got some things tabbed off here. Let me read somebody's recipes right here.
Tell me this thing.
Oh, this one is fantastic, bro. I made this fucking standard rib roast, bro. It's unbelievable, bro. Four rib fully trimmed roast, about 8-pound roast.
Yeah.
Salt, pepper, 2 carrots peeled and chunked, onions.
Wedge. Are you really reading a recipe book to me right now?
Yeah, bro, from the podcast people. Preheat from the my oven. 2 cups of beef broth, onions. You want to cut the onions into a wedge.
Yo,
then
cut
you
the fucking onions
on the side with the fucking.
Yo, get a butterfly knife comb and fucking cut those onions.
325. Place
there
the
you
meat
go.
Fat side up in a large
you
roasting
get those
pan.
Juices right
sprinkle
under your
it all
ass,
over with the salt,
with
the pepper. Guy. Scatter the onions around the meat, and at the end, I'm going to show you guys the picture.
Okay. Yeah.
Place
please.
The roast in the lower third of the oven.
Yeah, okay. Child pine.
Goes for 12 minutes to the Dory pound. Pine. So 8 times 12. For rare beef, you'll need about an hour 45, you know. Don't forget the brajol.
Brajol!
The temperature of the meat should be about 120, 125. Listen, if you're a real paisan, you don't measure any of this shit out. You just look at it and you know when it's done.
I don't even know what a fucking measuring spoon
and a thermometer is, all right? And you roast it a little longer for medium rare.
Undercooked and being food poisoned on a regular.
It says, if you don't want food poisoning, then it says the USDA recommends cooking meat to 145 degrees Fahrenheit, and that is considered well done.
Absolutely.
Transfer the meat to a cutting board.
Hold on, one second.
Now, this is the key part. Hold on. This is the key part.
Give me, no, let me. Let me. This is Joe Rogan. I'm on cocaine. I want to talk to you. All right?
Yeah, you're not Alex Jones, who's about to go to jail for life.
If we're talking steak here, the steak is only cut once, so you can sear the outside in that heat, and it'll be fine if it's under 145.
No, it's not a steak, it's a rib roast. Here, look at the picture. You'll see how it is. All
right, let me see this guy. All right. Well, as long as it's not ground beef, because if it's ground beef, everything is fucking mushed together, so you gotta cook all of it well done.
I'm telling you, bro, that fucking shit... The meat fell off the bone so much that I literally went to, like, I cut it and went to pull from the bone sticking out part like that, pull it up, and just the bone came right out of the meat. That was it. Nothing else. Not a speck on the bone either. Like,
yeah, I usually get the St. Louis-style pig pork ribs. You know what
I'm
saying?
Yeah, I think I grabbed something similar to these ribs over here. But
you got beef ones.
You gotta cover. This is the key part here. You gotta cover and foil it in aluminum foil for about 20-30 minutes. You know, because you, especially if you're undercooking it a little, you want it to, you know, settle in there nice, right? Then while you're letting it go, you spoon the fat off the roasting pan and add the beef broth to the pan and place it over medium heat. Then cook the scraping up ground bits in the bottom of the pan with a wooden spoon for several minutes until lightly reduced. Strain the juices into a heated gravy bowl. That's telling you how to make the gravy for it.
Yeah.
Carve the meat and serve with the juices. Now, I didn't do this, but I just thought of an extra to it because I'm a paisan and knows how to cook.
Talk about it.
You could add some brown sugar or maple brown sugar, maple honey sugar to the fucking gravy and give it more of like a fall mapley taste to it or a brown sugar taste to it. Give it that extra little pizzazz on there. You could do that.
Gordon Ramsay over here.
So this,
I mean, it honestly depends on what flavor.
Rib roast.
Artie Bucco.
What's the flavor profile you're going for the rib roast? Are you going for like a sweet? Are you going for more savory?
Well, that's because
if I was taking the gravy boat and the meat and the bits and chunks and cooking it up myself, I'd throw in the fresh onions, the fresh rosemary, fresh thyme right in there. Boom. If you're going for like a sweet and savory, or like more of a savory, salty garlic, or
brown sugar.
God damn it, I can't talk right now. Gravy. So if you're going with the brown sugar, that's what I'd probably go with, more of like a barbecue roast. Like a honey barbecue glaze with brown sugar.
Yeah, see the onions, when you put it in the pan and you lay the rib rack down on the pan, what you do with the onions and carrots that you've chopped up is you put them on the side of it. So then like you get those like baked onions. And actually what I did also was I took up the potatoes and I wrapped them in foil and I put them around there and I let the potatoes bake in there with it too.
It's not a bad idea. You're saving all that meat. You're doing it all at once.
And that,
but they're the ones who suggest you take the... They're the ones who suggest you take that fucking beef grease and the bits and then cook it down into a gravy. That's when I would say add more of the sweet onions and the little thyme and a little bit of oregano. That's when you're going to want to, when you're reducing that down, you're going to want to get the caramelization of the onions and the thyme and the rosemary shit.
You see that? So now you got
If you're going for more savory, if you're going for like a sweet and you're doing more of like a Hawaiian grill where you got your pineapple and ham and all that stuff, or you're going to go with the more brown sugar glaze for that, or like a honey barbecue. But if you're going for like a traditional pot roast, and you're kind of going for like a salty savory, I would definitely go with the fresh chives, onions, garlic, and stuff when you're making down your gravy.
All right, now you know. And with that, folks, we are going to raid your stoner girlfriend. Enjoy your day. This has been
my stoner girlfriend.
Bush. Yeah, my
smoke
stoner
more
girlfriend.
Weed, drink more water.
Thought yeah, it was your stoner girlfriend.
You heard it here. Check out the man Jedekiah. His music's fly. All right, we'll see you later.
Yo, when we all link up and get lucky.